Hello students, in this practical we will consider the spectrum analyzer. So in the last practical we have considered DSO, so that is time domain instrument. Now in this it is a spectrum analyzer, so it is a frequency domain instrument. So I have connected signal generator to the spectrum analyzer. So last time we have seen already the signal generator front panel. Now this is related with the spectrum analyzer front panel. So front panel is a quite complicated or more number of buttons those are there, but we are not considering all those one. We will consider whatever that is useful to us. So right now I have selected 3 kilohertz sine wave frequency that is given to the spectrum analyzer. Now we want to observe the spectrum, so that means frequency domain. So for that purpose, what we are considering is, we will go for the menu, this one. So within the menu, we will consider the MKRFREQ, that button, okay? So this third button. So we will consider that one. So this is the menu that is appearing there. So within this menu, we will consider the seventh option, so that is frequency start stop menu. So we will go for seven. So it will be now coming as a frequency start entry and frequency stop entry. So with the frequency start entry, that means zeroth option, so that we will select. So zeroth option, so frequency start value, a new value, so we will consider that as a something like 1 kilohertz. So 1 and kilohertz, megahertz, gigahertz, these buttons are there. So 1 kilohertz, that is what the thing. Then we will consider the second option. So here you can see the start entry is entered there. So 1 kilohertz. So stop entry. So we will consider frequency stop entry, that as a one number option. Okay, here it will be one number option. So here we are considering that one, that one. So enter new value. So you can consider 50 kilohertz, you can consider 100 kilohertz, like that, but it will take the minimum value, your minimum gap of 100 kilohertz, okay? That is what it is considered. So we will consider that as a 100 kilohertz. So you can see here 1 kilohertz is the start entry and 101 is the stop entry, kilohertz, of course, okay? Now you can press any key to exit from the menu. So you can press any key here, okay? So here you are getting the things. So here you are getting the observation. So sine wave that you are getting there. So with the sine wave, it is a pure sine wave. So only fundamental frequency that you are getting. Okay, now you can consider here, this will be expanded. So as this will be expanded, so that means you can say that as a span that is to be increased. Okay, so that will be increased. I am increasing that span, or we will decrease it. What will be the effect? That one. So only fundamental value that you are getting. Okay. Now here, one bright spot that you are getting, this one, one bright spot that you are getting, so that you can change by considering the marker, okay? So here I will put it on the top, so it will be indicated as a 1 kilohertz, that will be displayed there. So wherever the marker that is there, so that value will be indicated here. So frequency will be indicated, power will be indicated, dB, so that will be power, okay? That thing. Now with the sine wave, this is what you are getting. Now I will change the function. So from the sine wave, I will go to the square wave. So with the, whenever I am going for the square wave, more number of harmonics, those will be displayed there, those will be coming there. I am selecting now the next function, so that will be triangular one, okay? That one. sine square triangular. So triangular, so with the triangular you are getting the distortion that is somewhat less. With the square wave you are getting more distortion. With the sine wave you are getting pure sine wave, so the minimum distortion that you are getting. Okay, so you can change that marker, this position. So marker position that will be changed. So here it will be 8.2 kilohertz, here it will be 13 kilohertz, here it will be 20 kilohertz, here it will be 22 kilohertz, like that. That will be the way. So here this is what it is, a spectrum analyzer in short. So what is the option, or what are the options those you are selecting? So it will be go for the marker frequency menu. Okay, that one. So go for the seventh option, frequency start stop, then go for the frequency start entry stop entry, and those you then you can enter those values. So that will be the way. So that is what it is, a spectrum analyzer in short.